Hello everyone, welcome to Prudent Classes. My name is Shivam Maheshwari and in this video we will discuss about a very important topic of IBO 1 International Business Environment, and this topic I have chosen from Unit 13, and this is the part 1 of the video. Unit 13 is International Financial Institutions, and the topic that we are going to discuss in this video is about IMF. We'll know what IMF exactly is, and we will also discuss the objectives of IMF in details. So both the points in this question are pretty much important and are exam oriented questions. Okay, so I would like every one of you to pay attention and watch the video till the end and understand each and every concept properly. And also guys, do subscribe to my channel to get notification of further videos which I'll be uploading soon. And also you can watch my channel's playlist for further videos, okay? So let's discuss our topic one by one. So first we'll discuss about IMF. So we'll discuss what IMF exactly is. So the question can be write a short note on IMF or what is IMF, okay? So let's talk about the point number one. The point number one is the International Monetary Fund. IMF is an international organization with its headquarters in Washington, D.C., okay? Very simple point. So what is IMF? First thing that you need to understand, the full form of IMF. So the IMF full form is International Monetary Fund, okay? So IMF stands for International Monetary Fund. It is an international financial organization, or you can say international financial institution, and it has its headquarters in Washington, D.C., okay? Point number one is very simple. IMF stands for International Monetary Fund. It is an international financial organization and it has its headquarters in Washington, D.C. I hope first point is pretty much clear and you have understood it properly. Now guys, let's proceed to our point number two. So International Monetary Fund consists of 189 countries. Okay, how many countries are member of IMF? So International Monetary Fund, IMF, consists of 189 countries. And all these countries are working hard to foster global monetary cooperation, to secure financial stability, facilitate international trade, promote high employment and sustainable economic growth, and also to reduce poverty around the world. Okay, so this is our point number two. I'll repeat it, just try to remember all the points properly. So the first thing that we discussed in the point number two is IMF consists of 189 countries, okay, and all these countries are working first to foster global monetary cooperation, okay, foster global monetary cooperation. Second point is to secure financial stability. Third point is to facilitate international trade. And the fourth point which IMF is helping in is to promote high employment and sustainable economic growth. Promote high employment and sustainable economic growth. And the fifth point is the reduction in poverty around the world. That is again an important objective of IMF, okay, to reduce the poverty around the world, okay. So all these 5 points are very important, due to which we set up IMF. So IMF consists of 189 countries working to foster global monetary cooperation, secure financial stability, facilitate international trade, promote high employment and sustainable economic growth, and reduce the poverty around the world. Okay, I hope this slide is well understood by each and every one of you. If you have any doubt, you can watch this video once again and you can clear your doubts. Okay, so let's proceed to our slide number two. So guys, slide number two is on the screen. So we'll discuss two more important points about IMF. Okay, so the point number three says International Monetary Fund, IMF, was formed in 1944 at the Bretton Woods Conference, primarily by the idea of Harry Dexter White and John Maynard Keynes. Okay, so when was IMF formed? IMF was formed in 1944. What is the full form of IMF? It's International Monetary Fund. It was formed in 1944. Where was it formed? At Bretton Woods Conference. And who formed IMF basically? So IMF was formed primarily by the ideas of Harry Dexter White and John Maynard Keynes. Okay, Harry Dexter White and John Maynard Keynes. So these names should be remembered by you. So IMF was formed in 1944 at the Bretton Woods Conference, primarily by the ideas of Harry Dexter White and John Maynard Keynes. Okay, I hope point number 3 is clear to all of you. Now let's talk about the point number 4. So point number 4 says IMF came into formal existence in 1945 with 29 member countries with the goal of reconstructing the international payment system. Okay, so when did IMF come into formal existence? So International Monetary Fund, IMF, came into formal existence in 1945, and how many member countries joined IMF at that point of time? So there were 29 member countries who joined IMF in 1945. And what was the goal at that point of time? So the goal of IMF at that point of time was to reconstruct the international payment system. Okay, so point number 4 says International Monetary Fund, IMF, came into formal existence in 1945 with 29 member countries with the goal of reconstructing the international payment system. So the goal was to reconstruct the international payment system, to create the international payment system. 29 member countries were part at that point of time, and it came into formal existence in 1945. So I hope point number 4 is also clear. All 4 points are very simple. Now we'll proceed to our slide number 3. Okay, so let's proceed to slide 3. Now you can see the slide 3 on your screen. Let's talk about the point number 1 in this slide. So International Monetary Fund, IMF, is now playing a central role in the management of balance of payment difficulties and international financial crisis. So guys, if we talk about this point, so according to this point, IMF is playing a very, very crucial role in the management of, financial crisis and balance of payment issues that are faced by the member countries. So the entire purpose of creating IMF is to assist countries to deal with their financial problems. Okay, so just remember this point. IMF is now playing a very, very crucial and a central role in the management of balance of payment difficulties and international financial crisis. Okay, now let's talk about the next point. So countries contribute funds to a pool through a quota system from which countries experiencing balance of payments problem can borrow money. So if we talk about International Monetary Fund and IMF, the funds are collected by the member countries. So what member countries are doing, they are contributing funds to a pool through a quota system, and from which the countries which are facing the balance of payment difficulties, they can borrow money. So in that way, IMF, International Monetary Fund, is working as a source of funds or financial assistance to the countries who are facing financial or balance of payment difficulties. Okay, I hope this point is also clear. So countries contribute funds to a pool through a quota system from which countries experiencing balance of payment difficulties or any other financial crisis, they can borrow money. Okay, now through the fund and other activities such as the gathering of statistics and analysis, surveillance of its members' economies, and the demand for particular policies, the IMF is working to improve the economies of its member countries. So the whole and the sole purpose of creating International Monetary Fund is to improve the economies of its member countries. And how International Monetary Fund, IMF, is taking care of the member countries' economy improvement, it is taking care of it by providing the required funds, and also by gathering the information about the economy, then also by surveillance of the member economies, and also implementing required policies as well. So by implementing required policies, by doing the surveillance of the member countries' economies, and by gathering the important statistics and analysis, IMF is playing a very crucial role in the development of the economies. Okay, so I hope this point is also clear, and you can read all these points once again, and I request each and every member to go ahead and write this answer. Once you are done with the video, write an answer once so that you can remember it for a long time. Okay, so now let's proceed to our next point. Okay guys, now we'll discuss about the objectives of International Monetary Fund, IMF. Till now we discussed the important points about IMF. What is it? When was it formed? How many members are there? How does it work? How does it collect funds? How does it help the member economies? So we discussed a lot of points. Now we'll discuss about the important objectives of IMF, and this is one of the most important topic of this video, and I want each and every one of you to pay attention on all six important objectives that we are going to discuss ahead. Okay, so guys, if I talk about you can get a question like explain the objectives of IMF in 10 marks. So you have to explain all the objectives properly. So if we talk about the objectives of International Monetary Fund, so the objectives of International Monetary Fund is mentioned in the first article of the fund's charter. So where are the objectives of IMF mentioned? So it is mentioned in the first article of the fund's charter. I'll highlight it. See on the screen. So all the important objectives of IMF are mentioned in the first article of the fund's charter. Where is it mentioned? First article of the fund's charter. Now let's talk about what are these objectives. So first is the to promote cooperation. Second important objective is the balanced trade growth. Third is the exchange stability. Fourth is the exchange restriction elimination. Fourth one is exchange restriction elimination. Fifth one is providing financial resources, and the sixth important objective is reduction in balance of payment imbalances. Now guys, we'll discuss all these important objectives one by one. So let's proceed to our objective number one. So the objective number one is promote cooperation. So the first and the foremost objective of International Monetary Fund, IMF, is to promote international cooperation. Okay, let's repeat. The first and the foremost objective of International Monetary Fund, IMF, is to promote international cooperation. And how is it done? It is done by providing the machinery for consultation and collaboration by its members on international monetary issue. So how does the international cooperation is promoted by International Monetary Fund? It is done by providing the machinery for consultation and collaboration by the member of the International Monetary Fund on international monetary issues. Okay, so let's repeat the point. The first and the foremost objective of International Monetary Fund is to promote international cooperation by providing the machinery for consultation and collaboration by its members on international monetary issues. Okay, I hope this point is very much clear to you. It's a very simple point, and I have tried to write in a very simple language so that you can learn it very easily. Okay, so let's proceed to our point number two, or you can say objective number two. So guys, the second objective is balanced trade growth. Balanced trade growth is the second objective. So now let's talk about this particular point. So the second objective of the International Monetary Fund, IMF, is to facilitate the balanced growth of international trade, and through this contribute to high levels of employment and real income and the development of productive capacity of the economy. Okay, so what is the second objective of IMF? The second objective of International Monetary Fund is to facilitate the balanced growth of international trade. What? Facilitate the balanced growth of international trade, and through this contribute to high levels of employment and real income, and finally the development of the productive capacity of the economy. So in simple terms guys, if I talk about the growth in the international trade will lead to the growth in the employment level, and the growth in the employment level will lead to increase in the income of the employees, or you can say the people of the economy. And if the income of the people of the economy increases, then what will happen? It will lead to the development of the productive capacity of the economy, so which in turn will lead to the growth of the economy. Okay, so I hope the point number two is also clear to all of you. Let's talk about the point number three, or the objective number three. So the third objective is on the screen, which is related to exchange stability. Okay, so the third objective of International Monetary Fund, IMF, is to promote exchange stability and orderly exchange arrangements. Okay, so what is the third objective of IMF? The third objective of IMF is to promote exchange stability and orderly exchange arrangement. In addition to this, if we talk about, IMF is also required to facilitate the avoidance of competitive currency depreciation. Okay, IMF is also required to facilitate the avoidance of competitive currency depreciation. So IMF has to take care of that no country is leading to competitive currency depreciation. It always try to avoid these kind of situation which can, you know, damage the economy and the world trade. Okay, so let's repeat the point number three. The third objective of IMF is to promote exchange stability and orderly exchange arrangements and facilitate the avoidance of competitive currency depreciation. So now, guys, I'll let you know about the competitive currency depreciation. So what is competitive currency depreciation? Let's talk about it. It's a very important point and you should have information about this point as well. So guys, if we talk about the competitive currency depreciation, so it refers to a situation or a condition in international trade where countries, try to gain a trade advantage over other countries by reducing the exchange rate of their currency in response to other currencies. Okay, so what they are doing, they are reducing the exchange rate of their currency. So as a result of this, what is happening? The countries, export become more competitive in other countries and import into that particular country become more and more expensive. So if any country is reducing the exchange rate of their currency, so they are making their export attractive to other countries, and importing in that particular country become more and more expensive. So many countries try to gain the advantage of this particular situation. So International Monetary Fund, IMF, always try to avoid these kind of situation and always try to ensure a free and fair trade competition. Okay, so I hope this point is also clear to all of you. Now we'll proceed to our point number four, or the objective number four. Okay, so the fourth objective is exchange restrictions elimination. Okay, so the fourth objective of the International Monetary Fund, IMF, is to encourage the development of a multilateral system of payments and transfers for current transaction and seek the elimination of exchange restrictions which hamper the growth of the world trade. Okay, so what is meant by multilateral system of payments? It means that a country can make a payment for their purchases, or you can say import and export, through different sources or different ways. Like you can do bilateral transaction, you can pay in that particular currency, or you can pay in gold or silver. Depending upon your condition, a country can pay for their trade transactions. So, and the entire purpose of developing the multilateral system of payment and transfers for the current transaction is to eliminate the exchange restrictions which hamper the growth of world trade. Okay, so the fourth objective of International Monetary Fund, IMF, is to encourage the development of a multilateral system of payments and transfers for current transaction. Please pay attention. We are just talking about the current transaction, not about the capital transaction. So IMF encourage the development of multilateral system of payments and transfers for current transactions only, and seek the elimination of exchange restrictions which hamper the growth of world trade. Okay, so I hope the point number four, or the objective number four, is also clear to all of you. Now let's talk about the objective number five. So the fifth objective of International Monetary Fund is providing financial resources. Okay, so let's talk about it. So the fifth objective of the International Monetary Fund is to make financial resources available to its members on a temporary basis. Okay, just pay attention to this particular point. All the financial resources that will be provided by IMF will be available on a temporary basis, not on a permanent basis. Okay, so I repeat, the fifth objective of the International Monetary Fund is to make financial resources available to all its members on a temporary basis. Okay, is to make financial resources available to its members on a temporary basis. So this is a very simple point, self-explanatory. I hope you all understood it. So let's proceed to our objective number six. So guys, in this slide, we'll discuss the sixth objective, which is reduction in balance of payment imbalances. Okay, reduction in balance of payment imbalances. So the sixth objective of the International Monetary Fund, IMF, is to reduce both the duration and magnitude of balance of payment imbalances. Okay, just read this particular point once again. To reduce both the duration and magnitude of the balance of payment imbalances. So this is the sixth and the last objective of International Monetary Fund, which is the reduction in the duration and magnitude of balance of payment imbalances. So apart from that, IMF, with adequate safeguard or safety, permit its member countries to correct the balance of payment imbalances without resorting to measures destructive to national or international prosperity. So I repeat this point once again. Just remember this point. It's a very, very important point. So IMF, with adequate safeguard or safety, permit its member countries to correct the balance of payment imbalances without resorting to measures destructive to national or international prosperity. So this is one of the most important objectives of International Monetary Fund. It takes care of its member countries in reducing their balance of payment imbalances, and you know, also ensure that no country or no member of IMF is you know, choosing or using measures which can destroy the domestic or the international trade. Okay, so let's repeat. The sixth objective of International Monetary Fund is to reduce both the duration and magnitude of balance of payment imbalances. IMF, with adequate safety, permit its member countries to correct the balance of payment imbalances without resorting to measures destructive to national or international prosperity. So we have discussed all the important points. I hope you all liked this video. If you liked this video and you want further videos like this, give a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Also press the bell button so that you can get further notification of my videos. Okay, so thank you for watching, and perform your best in your exams. Bye bye.